Well, my dear friends, first and foremost, let me welcome each and every one of you all to this beautiful state of Goa. I'm 100% sure these 3 days that you're going to spend here in Goa will be always memorable. And especially after having such a terrific 2020, when we could not go out at all, I think this will be the first time that we are venturing out of the state of whatever place you're coming from. And that also Goa is welcoming you for this program. And with this warm welcome, I must say a very, very big thank you to the host, that is the JCI Fathoda Town, for giving me this unique privilege to come and address all of you all officers who are actually going to take up the reins of leadership as far as JCI is concerned. JCI, as I know personally, because I've been associated for the last 25 years from outside, being in the Lions Club member and being this right from the age of 21. Unfortunately, JCI Margao closed down that time. And that is the time when we were out of the JCI movement. And after that, being very, very active with the Lions Club, even reaching up to the district governor, this deputy district governor, we did a lot of things as far as Lionism is concerned. So today, since I have a very, very short time, my vision for the JCI as an organization, how can you actually make a difference? If you can make a difference, if each one of you all can actually put one photograph of yours in your office or you're in a bedroom with that sentence down below, one man can make a difference. Look at it every day during this tenure of yours, 1 year that you're going to get. And remember at the end of it, God will only ask you, I gave you the opportunity, what did you do with it? If you are able to answer that question on the 31st of December 2021, then automatically your success is guaranteed. But let me tell you one small thing as far as what actually defines success. In any organization, in any individual, in any career, in fact, if you know the answer, like what is the actual secret of success of all the self-made, I should say not millionaires or billionaires, of people who have made a difference to the whole world. Can anyone guess what is that secret of success? In fact, it has already been mentioned 3 times today morning by our pilot chairman as well as the chairman of the training. Forgive me for not knowing the names properly. So only the thing is because of that. But both of them have actually mentioned it.
Discipline
has to be there. But the most important thing. Why learning? Still I have not been attentive. Both have been stressing the same sentence again and again.
Why, what, how?
Transform.
Officer like quality.
No.
Time management.
No. See, that means you are still not attentive. What is the secret of success for any organization?
Teamwork.
These are all small things. But the secret, the main birth, I should say the foundation of success.
Team.
Leadership.
Team.
Leadership.
Leadership.
Open-minded.
They have already mentioned it today. Okay, I won't waste time. It's got nothing to do with this. I know Malikarjun is trying to joke on this. It's nothing to do on that. The basic thing is, all the leaders identify problems and provide solutions. If you don't identify problems and you don't provide solutions, you cannot be successful. So unless and until, now since JCI is handling the youngsters, the youth, the future citizens of the country, what is the biggest problem that most of them are going to face now? If you can visualize it, if you can have a vision about it, automatically you'll be able to provide a solution for it. And let me give you my vision of how I myself from the last 3 years have been doing it, and that's how I have been able to become so successful in life. Now, let me take, for example, the state of Goa itself. In Goa University, we produce over 14,000 graduates per year. 14,000 graduates are given the convocation certificate, they get their degree certificate, they get everything. Means they are highly qualified. But the biggest shock of my life when I got was, I was addressing the students of MBA Financial Services. It's supposed to be the cream of the society, which is like the highest paid course in the country. Because the fees for MBA financial services are the highest. And you just ask even those 60 students who are there in that batch, how many of you all have been taught how to manage money? Now you tell me, if you don't teach youngsters on how to manage money, they might have the highest qualification, they might stand first in class, but can they be successful in life? And what is the JCI mission? Is to empower the youth. And just check and see if in your training programs, you have ever conducted any financial literacy program. We conduct public speaking programs, we conduct time management programs, we conduct every program that we have. But do you feel that money is not important? I'll give you my own story as a dentist. I started my practice in the year 1990. But from that time, my focus was basically, if I make good money, that means I'm successful. And like this, luckily I joined the Lions Club of Margao at the age of 22 and I started roaming with all successful people who are 30 years older than me. So with the age difference and roaming with the rich, it's like when you roam with the eagles, you become an eagle. So the same way, by roaming with people who are 30 years senior to you and your business people, automatically you start developing these business qualities. And let me tell you, after completing 18 years of dentistry, setting up 3 clinics, putting up 1 dental lab, earning more than 1.5 lakh per month as profits, the biggest shock that happened in 2008 was, I just went for a national conference for 10 days to Delhi. It was our IDM, it's our Indian Dental Association National Conference, and I was the national secretary. When I attended that conference, when I come back to Goa after 10 days, what I realized, 10 days no income. Which means, as a doctor, I'm a daily wage worker. The day I don't go clinic, my income is zero. And then I ask myself, what did I do for the last 18 years? Where has the money gone? Money comes, money goes. Where it goes, God only knows. And I'm telling you, that shock which I got of my life is the one which made me today a crorepati. And today, even at 51, I'm already, the foundation is donating more than 1 crore per year for charity. Now from where has it come? It is only because I started learning about how to manage finances. I started to understand simple words, like what is the difference between a need and a want. Like I'll just give an example. Just 3 days back, one of my clients says, Doctor, now I have got a dream of owning a BMW. Now I can own a BMW. So I just asked him, do you need it or do you want it? He was speechless. He's saying, actually, I don't need it. And I said, why do you want to buy it? Just to show off? I'm telling you that thing, that vehicle will depreciate within 1 year. If even one person scratches it, you'll actually fall in trouble. Instead of that, do something for the community. Because rich is not how much you have, rich is how much you give. Understand that first. If you want to become rich, you have to make a difference to people's lives. If you want to become rich, you have to share your blessings with others. And only then you start becoming rich. So now, as an organization like JCI, from my experience as far as financial literacy is concerned, if you all really want to make a big difference to the whole country, if you want to make a difference to the entire population, especially the youngsters, if you want to empower them, let me tell you, if you all start focusing on one goal, you focus on one goal and you achieve it, and I'm telling you how JCI membership will be like on demand. People will start coming to your organization instead of we going and searching for them. And how to do it, I'll just give you one example through financial literacy. If each and every loan, or say for example, the entire JCI National this decides to train 1,000 teachers, or say 1 lakh teachers. Now all over India, you can make the figure as 1 lakh. In Goa, we can easily do it as 500 teachers. If we provide financial literacy classes for 500 teachers who are able to do the basics, all these videos are there on the YouTube which we have created, which are very simple. If you teach the basic things to the teachers, and you are able to get these teachers financially literate, you won't imagine each teacher can spread the news to so many others. So if the whole country, if all the lobes decide to do at least 1 teacher's training program on financial literacy and make a difference to one, say about 100 teachers per lobe, each chapter adopts around 100 teachers. Can you imagine with the focus going all around the country, training 1 lakh teachers on financial literacy can make a huge difference as far as India is concerned. So if you can take up, because this is going to be a very, very big problem for the youngsters today. Jobs are reducing because everything is becoming digital. number of graduates is increasing, so automatically job salary cuts are happening, and now 2020, now with work from home, automatically number of staff are also reducing. So with the job opportunities reducing, with the salaries decreasing, everything becoming digital, degree holders increasing, like MBA graduates increasing, or doctors increasing, or dentists increasing everywhere, competition is going to become very, very high. And let me tell you, the only stress that you can give, or the only weapon that you can use to fight poverty as well as fight suffering, is basically provide financial literacy. And let me tell you, growing rich in India is not difficult at all. It is basically the habits which matter. And if these habits are implemented from college days, anybody can become rich. And my mission is, I want all youngsters, especially those who are between 20 to 25, to start investing, to start understanding this concept, because the whole system as far as finance is changing. Like previously we used to say, okay, keeping money in the banks, getting 9%, 10% returns was good enough, because inflation was only 2 to 3%. Today inflation has gone to 8 to 9%, interest rate has dropped to 3%, it's going to become 2% very soon. So imagine when the interest rate falls down and you're still not keeping your youngsters aware about what is happening in the financial markets. What is going to happen to the youngsters? What is going to happen to the youth? I'm telling you, most of them will have to suffer just because of lack of financial knowledge. And unfortunately, I don't know why it is this. In the whole system, we don't find financial literacy in any class, whether it is MCOM, you take MSc, you take BSc, you take anywhere. Nobody teaches us anything about finance. I lost 18 years of my life because I was totally ignorant about stock market. And I used to say, my mother used to tell me, if you go into the stock market, you better leave the house only. Because if you start trading and all, that is not your subject. Because that is very, very risky. Actually speaking, I'll tell you, it's not risky at all. It is all what you understand from it. You have to understand only the two words. What is investing and what is trading? And what is saving? If you know these three words, 90% of your job is done. Like I say it very easily, the difference between trading and investing is like getting married, trading is like dating. You get pleasures only for that night. Whereas once you're married, you have to be with it for long. So in good times and in bad times, in sickness and in health, till death do us part. And you check and see, remain invested with any company, remain invested with any mutual fund, anywhere. Inflation itself will give you returns. And let me tell you, growing rich in India is not difficult. So my only prayer and humble request to all the JCI members, all the JCI office bearers who are going to take charge in 2021, try and take up as a mission, educate the teachers first, conduct teachers training programs on financial literacy, and just teach them the basics. If you want, there is one book kept in your kit. Go after the conference anytime in the evening or in the night when you are relaxing. There are the 10 financial commandments written on it. Anybody who follows these 10 commandments will actually experience heaven on earth itself. You don't have to die to go to heaven. Because heaven and hell are what you make on earth. Because I strongly believe when somebody else prays for you, you are in heaven. When you pray for yourself, you are in hell. So just understand that concept. And if you want others to pray for you, you have to make a difference to them. And always, God will only ask you one question. I have blessed you with this things. What did you do with them? Now you are getting a chance to be the zone president. You are getting a chance to become, that is an opportunity. Grab this opportunity to make a difference. Understand in what way can I actually make a difference to people. What is their suffering? What is the problem that they are facing? Provide a solution for it. And I'm telling you, you will enjoy your tenure. Thank you.